This problem is an example of an integral momentum balance. And what we have here is a 30 degree reducing bend. So this is within a pipe. And what we mean by 30 degrees is, let's say the velocity comes out, and this should be normal to our pipe. This is a 30 degree angle. So the mass flow rate of the water is 300 kilograms per second. We're going to assume frictionless flow with negligible gravitational effects, and the pressure at section one is going to equal 200 kilopascals. In addition, the diameter at section one is 0.2 meters. The diameter at section two is 0.15 meters. And as we said, our angle is 30 degrees. So let's start with the overall equation for this integral momentum balance. And basically what it says is the force, or the sum of the forces on the system, has to equal this material derivative, V rho dV, where this is volume, which is just d dt over the control volume of V rho dV. So that's our time dependence, plus over the control surface, V times rho V dot N dA. And keep in mind, all of these Vs are velocity vectors. And so what we're looking for here is the force that's required to keep this bend in place, and we're looking for the X and Y component. So this screencast is going to be about the X component. So that means the sum of the forces in the X direction is over the control surface, rho U, which is the velocity, that component in the X direction, V dot N dA. So if we write this out, we'll start at section one, and our rho, our velocity comes in this way. So our U is just positive V1. That's the X component, and it is, as we'll write here, in the positive X direction. Now we need V dot N, and V dot N is the velocity times the normal from the surface times the cosine of the angle between them. And as you can see coming in, the cosine of the angle between them is 180 degrees, and the cosine of 180 degrees is minus 1. So V dot N of flow coming in is negative. So this is minus V1, and we multiply this by A1. Now we have to go to section two, and so we have rho, and now we need to find the X component of that velocity coming out. So here's our velocity that comes out. Here's our angle, which is 30 degrees. And as you can see, the X component of that velocity is just V2 times the cosine of theta. And it's positive because it's in the positive X direction. V dot N, if you take a look at what's coming out, the velocity and the normal are parallel to each other, coming at the same direction. So the cosine of the angle between them is zero, and the cosine of zero, or the angle between them is zero, the cosine of zero is one. So this is just V2. That's our V dot N times A2. So that's our momentum on the left side. Let's take a look now at our forces. So what kind of forces do we have? Well, we have pressure. And if you remember, for pressure, it acts against the surface. So coming in, we have a positive P1A1. Now let's look at what's coming out. And here, our P2 is directed at the surface, control surface 2, and again, we have to look at the components that make up our pressure. And we can see that the X component is P2 cosine of theta, but it is in the negative X direction. So this is minus P2 cosine of theta times A2 plus the force that we're looking for. So if we write it in terms of this R sub X, this is rho V2 squared cosine of theta times A2 minus rho V1 squared A1 plus P2 cosine of theta A2 minus P1 A1. So we need to find some of these variables. So our V1 is just our mass flow rate divided by rho divided by A1, and that's 9.6 meters per second. Our V2 is found in the exact same way, except it's divided by A2, and that's 17 meters per second. To find P2, we use Bernoulli's, so that's P1 plus 1/2 rho V1 squared equals P2 plus 1/2 rho V2 squared. Again, we've assumed frictionless flow and that the gravitational effects are negligible. So we rewrite this. P2 equals rho over 2 V1 squared minus V2 squared plus P1. So P2 is 101.6 kilopascals. Now when we put our numbers back into our R sub X, we end up with 3,000 minus 3,184 newtons. One of the things to be careful of is that our pressure is given in kilopascals. You have to go from kilopascals to pascals. So for example, 101.6 kilopascals, you're going to have to write it as 101.6 times 10 to the third pascals.